This is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. For many other videos related to emergency medicine and the care of its patients, please go to edexitvideo.com. This video is about idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. Idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis is scarring or thickening of the lungs without a known cause. As you can see in the diagram and on the lung section on the right of it, the airspace are increased in size and thinned out and brittle. No one knows what causes pulmonary fibrosis or why some people get it. It causes the lung to become scarred and stiffened. This stiffening may make it increasingly difficult to breathe. In some people, the disease gets worse quickly, over months to a few years. But other people have little worsening of the disease over time. The condition is believed to be the result of an inflammatory response to an unknown substance. Idiopathic means no cause can be found. Or, like how I like to say, we are idiots because we can't find what's wrong with you. The disease occurs most often in people between 50 and 70 years old. Symptoms include chest pain, cough, which is usually dry, decreased tolerance to activity, and shortness of breath during activity. Signs and tests. The healthcare provider will perform a physical exam and ask questions about your medical history. Your doctor will ask whether you have been exposed to asbestos or if you have ever been a smoker. Patients with idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis have abnormal breath sounds called crackles. Patients with advanced disease may have blue-colored skin or cyanosis, as shown in the picture of the bottom left. This can happen around the mouth or in the fingernails due to low oxygen. Examination of the finger and toes may show abnormal enlargement of the fingernail bases called clubbing, as shown in the bottom right picture. Tests can help diagnose idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis include a bronchoscopy, which is putting a very thin tube down your airway into your lung, or a CT scan or computed tomography of your chest. Also, x-rays. The x-ray on the left shows the normal anatomy of an x-ray of the chest. On the right, you see a lot of fibrosis on this patient. Also, measurement of blood oxygen levels, pulmonary function tests as shown on the left, and a surgical lung biopsy. Tests for connective tissue disorders such as rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, or scleroderma are also done. No known cures exist for idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. Unfortunately, no medication has been shown to improve the outcome of patients with this condition. For some people, medications such as corticosteroids and cytotoxic drugs may help reduce swelling or inflammation in the airways. Ongoing clinical studies are experimenting with new treatments that have been shown to help some people with idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. Oxygen may be necessary in patients who have low oxygen levels. Lung rehab will not cure the disease, but it can help maintain exercise capacity. Some patients with advanced pulmonary fibrosis may need a lung transplant. Complications include chronic hypoxemia or chronic low oxygen levels, cor pulmonale, pneumothorax, which is a collapsed lung, polycythemia, which refers to elevated red cell count, pulmonary hypertension, and respiratory failure. It's important to call for an appointment with your healthcare provider if you develop a regular cough, if the cough is being productive of phlegm, especially if it's green, yellow, associated with fevers, etc. If your shortness of breath has changed. If you have fevers, chills, nausea, vomiting, trouble breathing, if your symptoms are progressing or there are new symptoms, you should come back to the emergency department for evaluation. For more videos like this one, please go to edexitvideo.com. But remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the care from a medical provider. Please take a minute to like my video and to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.